Hi boys and girls, it's great to be back with you again this week and to tell you more about our vital mysteries. But before we do that, boys and girls, we're going to talk to God. So we'll do a prayer drill again this week. So hands out, hands up, hands down, hands back up again. Close them, down, close your eyes as you come down, and let's talk to God. Heavenly Father, we just give you thanks for another opportunity to come to Kids Club. We thank you for all the boys and girls who are listening out there today. And we pray, Lord, that they will have fun and enjoy the story, Lord. And just ask that you'll be with us. In Jesus' name, amen.
Hi boys and girls, it's now time for a game. Tell me this, what is your favourite food? One of my favourite foods are baked beans. I love baked beans. I love beans on toast. I love beans with fish fingers. I love beans with chips. Well, today we're going to play the bean game. And all the leaders in the room, you can't see them because they're behind the camera. They're going to play as well too. So the bean game is, we've got a runner bean. So you're on the spot. Run, 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 run. You've got a jumping bean. So we jump, 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 jump. We have got a string bean, stretch up really, really tall. We've got a jelly bean, wibble, wobble, wibble, wobble, wibble, wobble, wobble, wobble. We've got a frozen bean, which means you do not move. We also have got a Mexican bean, hot, 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 hot. And we've got a microwave bean. Okay, so are we ready? Let's do some runner beans. Run, 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 as fast as you can, run really fast. Freeze. Let's go again. Jumping. Jump, 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 jump. Jelly bean. Jelly wibble, wobble, wibble, wobble, wobble. Freeze. Oh, some of you didn't stop in time. Let's do a microwave bean. Ping. Let's go again. Ping. Let's do a Mexican bean. Hot, 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 hot. One more. Let's do jelly beans. Wibble, wobble, wibble. And freeze. Listen, how to play the game. Let's do jumping beans again. Jump, 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 jump. Run a bean really fast. Run, 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 run. And a microwave bean. And ping. Good job, boys and girls, playing the bean game. See you all soon. Bye.
Such a lot when you got not a lot. Why? Be happy. I'm gonna jump up and down, gonna spin right around, gonna praise your name forever. I'm gonna shout out loud, gonna deafen the crowd, gonna send my praise to heaven. I'm gonna jump up and down, gonna spin right around, gonna praise your name forever. I'm gonna shout out loud, gonna deafen the crowd, gonna send my praise to heaven. Such a lot when you got not a lot. Why? Be happy. such a lot when you got not a lot. What? Be happy.
Hey boys and girls, it is time for our memory verse. If you have a good memory, you might remember that last week Aaron taught us the first half of the memory verse, and this is what the verse says. My thoughts are nothing like your thoughts, says the Lord. That's in Isaiah chapter 55, verse 8. And that just means that sometimes we don't understand why things turn out the way that they do. Maybe we don't understand at the minute why there's a pandemic happening and why we're having to watch kids come online instead of being there in person. But God understands why things are the way that they are. And He's in control and He has a good plan for us. We're going to learn the second half of that very same verse today. The second half of the verse says, and my ways are far beyond anything you can imagine. So God's ways, the way that God has planned things, are far greater and far better for us than what we could possibly imagine. So I need you all to say it together with me on the count of three. Three, two, one. And my ways are far beyond anything you could imagine. Isaiah chapter 55, verse 8. Not bad, but maybe we can take it a bit slower. So what we're going to do is we're going to say it all together, but really slowly. Imagine that you're moving in slow motion. So three, two, one. And my ways are beyond anything you could imagine. Isaiah chapter 55, verse 8. You all slowed down enough? Okay, good, because it's time to speed it up. I want you to say it with me as quickly as you possibly can. Three, two, one. And my ways are far beyond anything you can imagine. Isaiah chapter 55, verse 8. Okay, not bad. But to finish off, what I want you to do with me is look at this remote. Because every time I point this remote at you, I want you to get a little bit faster. So we're going to start off really slow, and then every time I point the remote at you, I want you to speed up and speed up until we're going really, really fast at the end. You ready? Three, two, one. And my ways are beyond anything you could imagine. Isaiah chapter 55, verse 8. Amazing job, boys and girls. And we will see you again next week to finish off the memory verse. Bye.
You're good to me. boys and girls, it's me, Jenny, up at church. Church is not the same without you. Definitely a little quieter up here, but this is the best we can do. Boys and girls, I have got another Bible mystery for you this week. You are not going to believe me, but this is a true story found in 2 Kings, okay, which is in the Old Testament, about 850 years before Jesus was born, there was a man called Elijah. Now, if you remember me, I like a little bit of Lego to help me tell a story. So this, for tonight, is Elijah. Now, Elijah was a relatively old man at this stage of the story. And he had a very good friend called Elisha. Now, both men loved God. Elijah spent lots of time in prayer to him and talked with him. And God spoke to Elijah and talked to him. So Elijah and Elisha were very good friends. One day, they were out for a walk, chatting away to each other, and out of the blue, a chariot of fire, yes, a chariot of fire came from heaven to carry Elijah home. He was an old man, but this wasn't normal, boys and girls. This is impossible, you say. Yes, you would think so. But in the Bible, in Matthew, Jesus tells us with man, things are impossible. What but with God, even the impossible is possible. So Elisha went quickly to tell his friends what had happened. 50 of their friends, went out searching for Elijah's body for 3 days. 3 days! Did they find it, boys and girls? What a mystery. God had taken Elijah to heaven in a chariot of fire. He never died. He didn't have to. God took him that way. God can make impossible things possible. He's our creator. Our little minds will never fully understand that, boys and girls. But one day when we're in heaven, God willing, he will make it clear to us then. Boys and girls, what a powerful mystery. What a powerful story that we can read about in 2 Kings in the Old Testament. We're going to finish with a little prayer. Dear Lord, we thank you for these wonderful, wonderful mysteries in your Bible. We thank you that they remind us of your power. Lord, Lewis shared last week about creation and how powerful and wonderful you are, how mysterious to create the whole world in 6 days and rest on the seventh. And Father, this powerful mystery teaches us that with you, anything is possible. Help us to trust you with all of our hearts. Help us to learn to talk to you in prayer and to read your Bible so that we would become nearer to you, Father, so that we would become more faithful to you. Father, we leave all these things in your hands. Protect each child that watches these stories, these Bible clubs. In Jesus' precious name. Amen.
What's the crack? How you all doing? I hope you are excited for Kids Club tonight. Tonight in the Kids Club Challenge, we're going to try something out really cool. But I need you to go and get something. So we're going to give you 10 seconds to go and get the stuff you need. You're going to need a piece of paper and you're going to need a pen. You've got 10 seconds. Run and get it now. 10, 9, 8, 7, pause if you need to, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, have you got it? Okay, pen and paper. This week's challenge is we're going to draw a nice portrait of ourselves. You might be wondering why I'm wearing my hoodie back to front. Well, you see, this is the challenge. You're going to draw a portrait of yourself without being able to actually see. So, I'm going to pull my hoodie over my face. You might want to go and get a scarf or get mummy and daddy or someone whoever looks after you to go and blindfold you. But we're going to do this blindfolded. Just like this. So, here we go. You're going to have 30 seconds. We're going to have a bit of music. So we are. You're going to put your pen on the paper and 30 seconds starting now. Okay, what are you doing? I think I'm going to go nose first. Okay. carry the noses first, and I'm going to make my way up to the eyes. Yeah. And I'm going to do like a big figure eight for the eyes. And then that. Okay, going for the hair next. Oh, I forgot. I've got mouth. Somewhere about here. Okay, and that's us. 30 seconds up. Throw on a few wee extras if you need to. I'm going to go 2 years, people. Okay, take your blindfolds off. You're going to see your picture. What I want you to do is, I'm not going to be able to see your picture, but I want you to send in a photo, or get mummy or daddy to send in a photo of your picture. Boys and girls, would you like to see my photo?
Yes.
Can't hear you. Would you like to see my photo?
Yes.
Okay, this week on Art Attack, we have got the blind portrait. Quite good, boys and girls. I'm quite proud of that. I'm going to pin that in John's office, and I want you to be able to send me your photo, and I would love to see what you were able to come up with. I'll see you later. Bye!
Okay, boys and girls, I hope you've enjoyed Kids Club again tonight, just as much as we all have enjoyed being with you again this week. And we look forward again to seeing you next week, when we're just going to close our meeting in the word of prayer. Let's pray. Loving Heavenly Father, we thank you for Kids Club tonight. We thank you for all the boys and girls who've been taking part, who've been drawing themselves, and who've been listening to the stories, Lord. We just pray that you'll be with each one of them this week, Lord. We pray that you'll protect them and keep them safe. But we pray that, Lord, they know how much you love them and how much you care for them. And we just ask now that you'll part us with your blessing. In Jesus' name, amen.